The last Apple event in November 2020 focused mostly on emerging creators. But this time again, rather than focusing on professionals, Apple has focused on products that a family needs or an emerging developer needs. So what have they introduced in their new keynote? They have first updated the Apple services. For Apple Card, they have introduced the Apple Card family, which allows family members above 13 years to share their Apple Card within their family. Their next update is Apple Podcast, which has a new design. They also introduced channels which help the user to find new shows. Apple has also introduced Apple Podcast subscriptions, which enables new content with ad-free listening and many other features. The Apple Podcast subscriptions will be available in 170 countries by next month. Apple has also introduced a new theme, purple, for the iPhone 12 and the iPhone 12 Pro. After the updates on the services, they have introduced four products. Their first is AirTag. It is a small wireless device which connects to the Find My network in the Apple products. It is similar to how you can find your Mac using the Find My application on your iPhone or any other Apple product. But the uniqueness of the AirTag is that it can be kept in any item that you own, like car keys. This small but unique device starts at $29, and for four pairs, it starts at $99. It will be available on April 30th. Their next product is Apple TV 4K. It is built in with the A12 Bionic chip that brings a new big performance to the TV. This device supports high dynamic range formats such as Dolby Vision. This makes the device to play videos more smoothly with high quality and high resolution. It can play Dolby Vision at 60 frames per second. But the unique thing about the Apple TV 4K is that you can use your phone to improve the Apple TV 4K's picture quality. The iPhone uses proximity sensors to keep the phone on the on-screen target. The TV uses the phone's sensors in order to color balance the TV. The Siri remote was also given a new design. As it has contrasting controls, you can easily find and just hit the button you want. The remote is also touch-enabled. The cost of the Apple TV 4K will be $179 for 32GB and $199 for 64GB. It will be available in the second week of May. For the Mac, Apple has continued with its two-year Apple Silicon transition. The new MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, and Mac Mini have been redefined with battery and power efficiency, all thanks to the M1 chip. Apple has brought the M1 to two of its best products, starting with the M1 iMac. The new iMac was completely redesigned and is now available in many colors, which wasn't there on the iMac since its creation in 1998. The M1 iMac is really thin at 11.5 centimeters, which makes it thinner than the first iPhone. This is because of the logic board. It is decreased due to the M1 processor. The Intel versions of the iMac add a processor, graphics card, RAM, security chip, and an I/O chip in different parts of the board and a huge fan, making the Intel iMac very hot. But the M1 consists of all of these, which shrinks the space of the logic board. This enables them to keep two fans on both sides of the board. But the ports are all USB-C. As a result, the headphone jack is no longer behind the M1 iMac. It is now on the side, as the headphone jack is longer than the iMac. With this shrinking of the logic board, the M1 iMac now consists of 6 high-definition speakers. It consists of a 1080p FaceTime camera. Not only was the iMac redesigned, its accessories were redesigned too. The Magic Keyboard, Magic Mouse, and Magic Trackpad now comes in the colors of the iMac. The Magic Keyboard now also has Touch ID for the first time. The colors of the iMac bezels are white. As the iMac is thin, the Ethernet port is now on the power adapter, whereas the power adapter is now magnetic, which is pretty. This M1 iMac is perfect for families who need a desktop for classes, work, or for playing games. It is really powerful due to the M1 chip. This redesigned computer starts at $1,299 for 7-core GPU and a normal Magic Keyboard, and it costs $1,499 for the 8-core GPU and a Touch ID Magic Keyboard. It will be available in the second week of May. Nobody expected what the next product would have the M1 processor. It is the iPad Pro. This makes the iPad faster than its predecessor. The iPad can now run in high performance, which enables it to run powerful apps. The M1 iPad Pro now has a better performance than the M1 iMac, as it has an 8-core GPU. This M1 iPad Pro's GPU is 40 times faster than all of its predecessors. The iPad also has 4 speakers. With the CPU, GPU, and speakers, playing games on the iPad Pro is insanely fun. The M1 iPad's LiDAR scanner is even more better. The display of the iPad is also changed. The iPad normally has an HDR display, but now it has a Liquid Retina XDR display, which makes it better to work on than the Pro Display XDR. Now the iPad Pro has an extreme resolution and contrast ratio than a $5,000 monitor. The M1 iPad Pro delivers the best performance ever on an iPad. With this, you can play games, edit photos and videos, have an excellent video conferencing, watch some breathtaking movies with the display, and so much more. This popular redesigned device starts with $799 for the 11-inch and $1,999 for the 12.9-inch. It will be available in the second week of May. All of the products displayed by Apple were a part of their carbon neutral plan. The products and the boxes they come with are 100% recycled. The April keynote event 2021 was at its very best, but the most anticipated one is WWDC 2021 event in June.